Welcome to this video on how old is your little orchid? And when I say little, I mean little because it is easier to determine the age of your orchid from the start when it is a seedling, as opposed to if you receive a division, obviously. So I just wonder if anybody asks themselves the same question. And yeah, it's not really that common of a topic. And does it really matter? The answer is no, not really. But I think I might want to say it kind of does matter knowing how old your little seedling is, because it kind of would feed into how you need to take care of it. And not only that, what can you expect of it while it is maturing in your collection and hopefully become blooming size one day? This is just going to be a chat while we look at my two seedlings. I've got Lelia crispa here on the left and Cattleya maxima on the right. This is the Maxima cerula, which I got from the Orchid Room back in 2020. And I thought it would be a good idea to have two next to each other that came in 2020, simply because there is a difference between the two of them, which I will get into. But let's just go through how to calculate and get a pretty good idea as to how old your little orchid is. It all starts with flasking. First, we have to sow the seeds. So once the seeds have been sown, so to speak, the first years of an orchid's life, it is grown in vitro. So that is a very sterile environment. Seeing as the orchid seeds have no stored carbs of their own, lab technicians have to supply the media to initiate germination and growth and all of that good stuff. The seeds are put onto the media and will germinate in less than 1 year. That's your first year that you can calculate how old your orchid is, leading up to germination. So once they've germinated, the protocorms, those tiny, tiny little green dots, will then be thinned out a bit into separate flasks. And then it takes approximately 6 months for them to form the beginning of leaves and roots. Once they have some of these structures in place, they will get thinned out again to lesser numbers where they can grow to size, which will take another 6 months to a year before they're ready to be planted out. So before you see anything in a pot, 2.5 years have gone by. The year of germination and the year of thinning out and changing the flasks so that the little seedlings can mature and grow without crowding each other out. I'm gonna add another 5 months to that just to be on the safe side, so that we always have a calculation of starting from germination to deflasking 2.5 years. Because some of our orchids are being sent as flasks to the nursery where they will deflask, or even to us as private collectors. And if it is not absolutely necessary to deflask because the conditions inside the flask are still intact, they're not runny, they haven't got mold or anything in them, then we can hold on to those flasks even longer, keeping the little seedlings in that perfect environment for as long as possible. So before deflasking anything, calculating 2.5 years. That brings the orchids in this little flask to a total age of 2.5 years. Then let's just say that the orchid is still at the nursery, it's been deflasked, and let's just say that the nursery grows the seedlings on for at least another year, at least that's what they should do, to harden them off and make sure that they're healthy, stable, and can withstand the stress of shipping, having them somewhat established before selling them off onto the market. Now we are at 3.5 years. Meaning that when you receive your seedling, you can now start to calculate how old your orchid is based on the structures that are already there. And usually the orchid starts, of course, with the smallest little bulbs in the back and moves forward 1 year after the other with a new structure. It is very, very rare that a seedling has two directions of growth when it comes out of a flask. So we're going to calculate the little seedling back parts here, which are very evident because of the tiny, tiny leaves. Right here, that would be one. So that would be the 3.5 year aged little pseudobulb in the back. And then we can move forward and calculate the next small leaf right here. That is included in the 3.5 years because these are so tiny, they were in the flask. Then when it came to deflasking and hardening them off, this is usually the stage at which they are deflasked. We can now start to calculate which growths grew next, how many do we have, and add a year on top of that. So let's say this is 3.5 years, just out of the flask. 4.5 years, 5.5 years, 6.5 years, and 7.5 years. My seedling is 7.5 years old, plus minus. Now, by the time you come to this kind of a result, you've either just received your seedling and you can just calculate the 3.5 years plus one, hopefully, that was in the nursery, make it 4.5 years. So you know that your seedling has about an age of 4.5. And then every year that you grow on another bulb, you know the age of your seedling is increasing. Bear in mind that you have to take into consideration if no new growth has happened for a whole year because the seedling is acclimating. You have to remember that in the history of your orchid and its age, that it has skipped a year with a new growth. So my seedling here has 7.5 years behind it, according to my calculation, and this is the latest mature growth it grew, and beyond that, nothing in 2021, except for roots. It is finally pot bound. So I'm explaining this history-wise as well because it is important to understand that you have a seedling that comes in and you can see the structures and you calculate its age approximate when it arrives to you. But pretty close, 3.5 years is a good little margin to go by. And then you can say 4.5 years, 5.5 years, 6.5 years, depending on the structures you have. Never forget though, in the future, if you're trying to assess the age of your orchid, did you lose a new growth? And in my case, I did with my Cattleya Maxima Cerula because back in November, I was removing all the moss around the base, anticipating a winter with cold temperatures. I did not want to rot out the new growths. And well, I broke a new growth. So the new growth was already starting. By now, we should have seen it progress up to about here, but it's not there. And the orchid has been set back for a while it's figuring out where is its next eye. Seedlings normally only have one eye, one direction of growth. It'll figure it out. I just have to make sure I take care of it so that it gets time to figure it out and doesn't collapse. But then you've already added another year of no new growth, just like with the CRISPA. So keep that in mind when you calculate the age of your orchid. If a new growth is not accounted for because of breakage, however it gets lost, rot, pests, the orchid is still aging in years, so keep that in mind. Now, you say, well, that's easy. What about monopodials? Same thing. They still need their 2.5 years to germinate. They still have only maybe 2 leaves when they come out of the flask. And then, this is my KTC Kauki Chakut. And then the 2 leaves are the ones that you will probably receive in the mail. So you know 3.5 years is the age of the orchid, plus minus. I always hope that nurseries harden off their recently deflasked seedlings because they really need time to adapt to the outside world, and shipping them straight out of the flask is dangerous and, well, the orchid will not make it. But in the case of a monopodial, for example, I'm going to choose this one here because it's the smallest one I've got where I can show the closest example. Here's a leaf that had died off that you can see there. So I got the orchid with 1, 2 leaves, and then this one was just starting to show when I received it. So that's 2.5 years right out of the flask, 3.5 years at the nursery. I've got 2 leaves to count for. That would make my orchid 4.5 years, 5.5 years with the leaf that's over here, and then last year's leaf, 6.5 years. Not much to show for, but you can go back when you check your seedlings and check how many leaves have been lost from the base, the first leaf ever. And bear that in mind as well, similarly with any sympodial orchids, that the back leaves of the itty bitty seedlings may have dropped or will drop. Whatever you find when you receive your little seedling, you might see a suitable bear without a leaf. But it still counts as growth. And normally that is what would be in the flask. Your seedling leaves will die back relatively quickly, but that is just the nature of the game. They've served their purpose. It is now left up to the rest of the growth to do their job. I hope that this was of interest because I had an app a long time ago where I had to fill in all the blanks, all the information, all the detail, and it says, how old is your orchid? And I was like, I don't know. And then I thought, well, I'm gonna figure it out. How old is my orchid? And I thought maybe this would be of interest to share if you've ever thought about it, if it is even something noteworthy. But a quick video with regards to how old is your orchid, knowing when to count, what years to include, including having lost a growth. It still adds to the age of the orchid, even though you may not be able to see all the structures anymore because, you know, one growth is lost, but that is still a year that the orchid has aged. Clearly, when it comes to divisions and the like, that is not an option anymore. You can then only calculate the age of your orchid since she's been in your collection. But for these little guys, I thought it would be fun to run you by how to get there and how to gauge how old she is. Let me just say one thing. If you get a seedling in the mail that hasn't got a new growth starting, and it's only, let's say, as a monopodial, two leaves, or you have two little itty-bitty seedling leaves, and there is not a new growth starting, consider it a recently deflast orchid and treat it as such. Super high humidity, keep it away from direct sun. That orchid has not hardened off. All the nursery did was deflask it, put it in a pot, and send it to you, and then good luck. But yeah, if your orchid arrives with a new growth already starting back from the seedling bulbs, then your little orchid has been established for a whole year. So anyway, quick little nugget of information if you were interested. I appreciate you having spent time here with me today. I just wonder if you also thought about this question ever, or is it just me? I promise I have other things to do, but I just thought I'd bring this to your attention and see what interest is out there, if there is any. Have yourselves a beautiful day. Once again, on one condition though, that you stay safe. Take care. Bye.